in a way, they interpret and put into action their parliamentary immunity.
So was it worth it?
Sa akin, it's worth it. You know, today, we're talking about it. But in the past 30 years, we have seen people who just roll over. Na bahala ka na after maligning them, vilifying them, bahala ka nang magpaliwanag sa mga pamilya mo, bahala ka nang bumangon. Look, that's too irresponsible power that these powerful senators and congressmen unleashes to an innocent resource person. That's why they have to be more statesman-like. Yeah. You know, if they want to act like judges, then they should have to act like real judges. Talagang just, nakapiring ang mata. But if they want to use the power of judges and prosecutor to grandstand and vilify people they do not like faces, then that is too irresponsible.
Okay, now, before we go, it's clear that President Duterte trusts you. You agree? Because after all this, that fiasco in customs, although you did say nakalusot, lumusok nga from China, nahuli mo nga. That's a good point also, ha? Kasi kung nakalusot nga sa China, eh, that's such a powerful country with, I'm sure, their own rules in customs. Nakalusot, nahuli mo nga. People are asking, number one, eto muna. When you were cleared or your charges were dropped November 22, 2017, it was this very controversial Aristotle Reyes, the DOJ prosecutor, who dismissed the charges against you. But then he also dismissed charges, drug charges of Kerwin Espinosa and Peter Lim. So publicly, it doesn't look too good. I mean, he drops charges, diba? He drops the charges against many controversial personalities, drug, self-confessed drug lord, and then you. So it appears a little shady to some, you know, to the public.
First, I would like to take exemption.
Go ahead.
To me being projected along with these real drug lords now.
Because the name, the way it's the dropping of the charges, November 22 ka, December 20, magkakasunod kayong dinrop. Yeah. And then right now, he's promoted. So you can imagine how people are thinking that did President Duterte, in a way, did Malacanang use him to drop charges of certain personalities?
You know, these are I'm not really competent to answer this because I'm not in any way party to whatever actions the DOJ or...
you don't know him.
Yes. And then I believe there are some reports that even the president was not so happy about the case of this non-drug lord. So, but, you know, I'm not really competent and credible to answer those questions. I can only speak in behalf of my person.
But, okay.
You know, I just want to take exemption to my parallelism with those drug lords because I don't even smoke in my entire life. So, kahit sigarilyo, hindi ako nagsisigarilyo.
I don't think that was...
Ibig sabihin, when you go into drugs...
Yes, no, I don't think...
That's why sa akin, nasasaktan ako. You know, this is what...
No, sir.
They have succeeded. Eh.
Yeah.
The people have succeeded in saying, pinalusot mo yung drugs. Excuse me po. Mm-hmm. Hindi ko po pinalusot. Hinabol ko po. All accounted po yung drugs. Ayaw ko pong parangalan nyo ako. Pero ilabas po natin yung katotohanan. The truth is, nakalusot sa isang port namin, more than 30 ports po yan. In 3.5 hours, after I have received my information, that's midnight, pinahabol ko po yun at nahuli po natin yun. Eh, okay na sa akin yun, kahit yung asawa ko lang nagsasabing, asawa, okay lang. Ginawa mo naman yung trabaho mo. I don't ask for you to sympathize with me, but let's stick to the truth. Mm-hmm. Hindi ko pinalusot, hinabol ko po.
No. Pero clearly, the president still trusts you. It doesn't change. Because after customs, is the president put you as assistant secretary, that's your new rank, and deputy administrator of the Office of Civil Defense under the DND. So you still enjoy the trust and the friendship of the president. I'm just curious, after that whole customs fiasco, didn't the president speak to you in one way or Bongo tell you that Nick Faeldon, you still enjoy something, anything? Weren't you surprised he gave you another post?
No, because
how did he give it to
you? He knows the truth. Eh.
Okay.
You know,
so,
I have my boss. Eh.
Yeah,
I have my boss, si Secretary Dominguez.
Okay.
And go to the customs, go to Department of Finance. These are the people who really supervise me, who knows how I work, at the Bureau of Customs. You know, when some senators project, you know, at least you have 12 million supporters nationwide, and you have 3 senators, 4 senators, maraming supporters yan. That's why I'm appealing to these icons of the country, the senators. To be more responsible. You know, kawawa naman, may nagpakamatay na minsan dahil was vilified during the conduct of your...
Yeah.
Pag-aralan nyo naman yung ibig sabihin ng parliament. Yeah, and yung tao rin kami. We have our families. But okay lang yan kung talagang guilty ka. But yeah, when you are innocent at gaganyanin kayo, magre-reklamo ka talaga. Mm-hmm. Yo, they do not like me to have done this because this is unprecedented, yung ginawa kong questionin sila. But I will continue. I will guarantee you, dear senators, if you will continue to use your parliamentary immunity to malign innocent people, I will be forever your nemesis here. Because... Sino tatayo sa inyo? Kung hindi ko kayo tatayuan, sino pa po? Marami na pong biktima in the past 31 years that we have this new Senate, marami na po tayong nakitang kinawawa. You know, paupuin mo yung isang opisyalis dyan, paglabas niya, hindi na niya kilala sarili niya. Because trained siya in that few minutes to just say, yes, your honor, yes, your honor, yes, your honor. Kawawang mga tao. And we are actually mocking the entire society. You when you're senator and you're trying to mock people, when you try to show to the public that you can look, we are senators, we are governed by different laws, we are immune, we can do whatever we want. Those laws, hindi nyo kami pwedeng ipakulong kahit na-convict ka na nga ng ombudsman, hindi ka pwedeng ipakulong kasi hindi mag-congressman na lang tayo, mag-senator na tayo lahat because the law treats us differently from the ordinary citizens. I will continue to question this unequal treatment of the law. Dapat senator ka man lang o kahit congressman ka, dapat yung batas pantay-pantay sa atin.
Oo.
Dapat hindi, dapat sila
yung mas mababa. I agree with that. That one I agree.
Oo. Kasi ang pangit naman, look, we are senators. You just follow us. You just say yes to us. Well, of course, matatagal na silang nakarinig ng yes sa buhay nila. It's very painful for the rest. Minsan, bakit nagnonoy to sa akin? Eh, for all their life, 30 years, puro yes nang narinig ng mga yan eh. No one really says to them in their house, their staff, yes sir, nang yes na lang naririnig. And all of a sudden, some unknown person will say no to them. Talagang magagalit yan. Okay.